Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the lecture on the subject fluid mechanics and machines. And this is lecture number 8.1. We are going to discuss about the turbulent flow. The topic we are going to discuss, we introduce the turbulent flow. Reynolds equation for the turbulent flow, the Prandtl mixing length theory for the turbulent flow, velocity distribution calculation, the turbulent flow, friction factor in the turbulent flow, and we introduce the MODI chart for calculating the friction coefficient for the turbulent flow. So in the earlier lectures, we discussed about the flow through pipes, between plates, viscous friction and boundary layer theory, flow through laminar flow and the boundary layer theory we discussed earlier lectures. And the learning outcome for this lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to calculate the loss of heat in friction in turbulent flow, and the student will be able to discuss about the MODI chart. Look at the video. The flow in a open river, it is an example for turbulent flow. And the flow of water in the pipeline, in the tap at our home, it is also the example for the turbulent flow, the real practical example for the turbulent flow. And this is the laboratory simulation of the turbulent flow. The fluid particles are rotating, moving in a random fashion. And this is also the laboratory simulation of the turbulent flow. The smoke or the gas is flowing, turbulent flow, and this is also an example for turbulent flow. It is combustion of a flame. So all the practical flow, they are turbulent in nature. Laminar flow, it is very difficult to establish in practical situation, but at laboratory level, we create the laminar flow to study the behavior of the fluid particle. And the majority of the turbulent flow, there is no derivation, mathematical derivation, analytical derivation, because it is very difficult to predict the behavior of the fluid in the flow situation. So majority of the turbulent flow equations, they are experimentally developed, semi-empirical or experimental results are consolidated in the form of equation to calculate the parameters in the turbulent flow. So most of the real flow in pipe or open channel is turbulent. For the flow through pipe, if the Reynolds number is greater than 4000, the flow is turbulent. And the two flows, laminar flow and the turbulent flow, they are shown here in the diagram. For laminar flow, the fluid particles, they are moving in a streamlined motion, and here the fluid particles are moving in a random fashion. For laminar flow, the velocity profile, what we discussed earlier, it is in parabolic shape. But for the turbulent flow, the velocity profile is in flatter velocity profile. And this again, it shows the velocity profile for different Reynolds number. So for laminar flow, when Reynolds number is 10 power 3, it will be laminar flow. When it becomes 10 power 4 and 10 power 6, so it becomes more flatter when the Reynolds number increases. The velocity profile for laminar flow is a parabola, whereas for turbulent flow, the velocity profile is flatter. This is due to the uniform velocity distribution in the turbulent flow. So because of the random motion of the fluid particle, the velocity distribution is uniform within the pipeline. In turbulent flow, the fluid particles move in a haphazard manner, and the large scale eddies are developed, which results in complete mixing of the fluid particle. So in the turbulent flow, in some situation it is required and some situation it is undesirable. For example, in fluid mechanics it is undesirable because it creates more pressure drop, whereas in the case of IC engine, it is required for mixing of the fluid particle, mixing of the air and the fuel properly. Effective mixing of air and fuel, we require turbulent. So in the design of the IC engine, we intentionally design the component in such a way that turbulence is created when the air enters into the engine cylinder. Whereas in the flow through pipeline fluid mechanics, we have to be carefully designed that the turbulent flow, it will affect the flow, it will increase the pressure drop, it will increase the friction, and it will increase the pressure drop so that the pumping power required will be more in the case of turbulent flow. In turbulent flow, the velocity and the pressure fluctuates at a high frequency. Because of the fluctuation, the analytical solution of turbulent flow is highly complicated. Most of the solutions for turbulent flow are semi-empirical or empirical in nature. So, empirical means experimentally developed. So, CS test in turbulent flow, Bosniaku equation. So, the equation gives tau equal to, CSS tau equal to tau V tau T, that's equal to mu into du by dy plus eta into du bar by dy, where tau V is the viscous shear stress and tau T is the turbulent shear stress. So, mu is the dynamic viscosity and eta is the eddy viscosity and u is the velocity. So, the shear stress, there are two components, one is viscous shear stress and the turbulent shear stress. Reynolds in 1886 developed an expression for average turbulent shear stress between two layers of the fluid at a small distance apart is given as tau bar equal to rho u dash v dash bar, where tau bar equal to the average turbulent shear stress, u bar v bar dash, they are the average elastic component in the x and y directions due to the turbulence. In 1925, Prandtl, a German engineer, presented the mixing length hypothesis by using the turbulent shear stress can be expressed in terms of measurable quantities of velocity. According to the mixing length theory, velocity fluctuation in the x and y directions are given as u dash equal to L into du by dy and v dash equal to L into du by dy. And the u dash v dash bar equal to L square into du by dy whole square. The total shear stress at any point in the turbulent flow is the sum of the shear stress due to the viscous shear and turbulent shear. Therefore, tau bar equal to mu into du by dy plus rho L square into du by dy whole square. So, this is the Prandtl mixing length theory. So, using the mixing length theory, this is the equation for the shear stress. Then the velocity distribution, the turbulent flow in the pipeline. So, Prandtl universal velocity distribution equation for turbulent flow, it is given as u equal to u maximum plus 2.5 into u star into logarithmic of y by r, where u star is the shear stress, which is shear velocity, which is square root of tau o by rho, where tau o is the wall shear stress, rho is the density of the fluid. U max is the maximum velocity, R is the radius of the pipe, and Y is the distance from the pipe wall. The velocity distribution for turbulent flow in a smooth pipe, the velocity distribution in smooth pipe is given by U by U star equal to 5.75 into logarithmic of U star Y divided by nu plus 5.55, and where Y is the distance, nu is the kinematic viscosity. The velocity distribution for turbulent flow in smooth pipe in terms of average velocity is given by capital U bar by U star equal to 5.75 log 10 of U star Y divided by nu plus 1.75, where U bar is the average velocity, which is Q by pi r square. So, Q is the discharge, R is the radius of the pipe. Then, Nicolas C. expressed the velocity distribution for turbulent flow in a smooth pipe in exponential form as u by u max equal to y by r to the power 1 by n, where the 1 by 1 equal to 1 by 6 for Reynolds number 4 into 10 power 3, the 1 by n equal to 1 by 7 for Reynolds number 1.1 10 power 5, and 1 by n equal to 1 by 10 when the Reynolds number is greater than 2 into 10 power 6. Velocity distribution for turbulent flow in rough pipe. The velocity distribution for turbulent flow in rough pipe is given as u by u star equal to 5.7 by log 10 y by k plus 8.5. Then the velocity distribution for turbulent flow in a rough pipe in terms of average velocity is given by u star equal to 5.75 into log 10 of r by k plus 4.75, where u bar is the average velocity, which is q by pi r square. And Q is the discharge, R is the radius of the pipe, and K is the Korman's constant. Then the loss of head due to friction in the pipeline. So in the turbulent flow situation, so we assume a lengthy pipe of section 1 and section 2, flow section 1 and 2. So where L is the length between section 1 and 2, D is the diameter of the pipe, F star is the frictional resistance per unit wetted area per unit velocity, HF is the loss of head due to friction, P1, P2 are the pressure at section 1 and 2 respectively, V1, V2 are the velocities at section 1 and 2 respectively. Now applying the Bernoulli's equation between section 1 and 2, so P1 by W plus V1 square by 2G plus Z1 equal to P2 by W plus V2 square by 2G plus Z2 plus HF, where W is the specific weight, pressure P is the pressure, V is the velocity, Z is the elevation and HF is the loss of heat due to friction. But Z1 equal to Z2 for horizontal pipe, V1 equal to V2 for constant pipe area, so this equation simplified as P1 by W equal to P2 by W plus HF. So HF, the head loss due to friction equal to P1 minus P2 divided by rho into G. So specific weight equal to rho into G. Rho is the density, G is the acceleration due to gravity. So the frictional force acting on the fluid is given by F equal to frictional resistance per unit wetted area per unit velocity into wetted area into velocity square. So which is F star into pi dl into v square. So wetted area equal to pi dl, velocity is the v. The force acting on the fluid element at section 1 and 2. So at section 1, the pressure force P1 into A. At section 2, the pressure force P2 into A. And the frictional force between 1 and 2 is F. So the net force acting on the horizontal pipe, net force acting in the horizontal direction is 0. So therefore, P1A minus P2A minus F equal to 0. So P1 minus P2 into A equal to F, where F equal to F star pi dl by V square. So P1 minus P2 equal to F star pi dl V square divided by A. Now from the previous equation, P1 minus P2 we derived as HF rho into G. So substituting value HF into rho into G equal to F star pi dl V square by A. So rearranging HF equal to F star by rho G pi dl by pi by 4 d square, area equal to pi by 4 d square into v. So simplifying, f star by rho into 4 l v square by g d. Now the f star by rho equal to f by 2, then the HF equation, HF equal to 4 f l v square by 2 g d, which is Darcy, f is the Darcy coefficient, and the 17, equation number 17, this is known as Darcy-Weisbach equation, which is used to determine the head loss due to friction in the pipeline. The same equation we derived for the laminar flow also, HF equal to 4 FL V square by 2 GD. So the head loss due to friction in the flow through the pipeline. And here the length is, L is the length of the pipe, V is the V square velocity of the fluid, D is the diameter, and the parameter F is the friction factor. So the friction factor is very important parameter to calculate in the turbulent flow situation or flow through the pipeline. The equation sometimes it is written as HF equal to F1 into L V square by 2 GD, where F1 is the friction factor, which is 4F. Now the friction factor for laminar flow, it is given by F equal to 16 by Reynolds number. Whereas for the turbulent flow, the friction factor is given by various researchers, Blasius equation, Nicurat's equation for other laminar flow. Alternatively, we can use, there are four different equations. Depending on the Reynolds number value, we can select the appropriate equation. So Blasius equation, where Reynolds number is less than 10 power 5, greater than 4000, F equal to 0.0791 divided by Reynolds number to the power 0.25. Nicurat's equation for Reynolds number less than 4 into 10 power 6, greater than 10 power 5. So 1 by square root of 4F equal to 2.03. logarithmic of log 10 into log 10 of Reynolds number into square root of 4F minus 0.91. Nicurat's equation, when the Reynolds number is less than 10 power 4 into 10 power 7 and greater than 10 power 5, we can use 1 by square root of 4F equal to 2.0 into log 10 of RE into square root of 4F minus 0.8. Alternatively, we can use this equation, common equation, 0.0008. plus 0.05525 divided by Reynolds number to the power 0.237. And using any one of the equation, we can calculate the F value, the friction coefficient for friction factor for the turbulent flow. Then we can substitute in the HF equation to calculate the head loss due to friction. And the friction factor for the turbulent flow in the rough pipe. So, Nicorazzi experimentally suggested the following equation for friction factor for turbulent flow in a rough pipe. So, 1 by square root of 4F equal to 2.0 log 10 of R by K plus 1.74. Or friction factor for commercial pipe. So, commercial pipe. Colebrook and White developed an empirical equation for variation of friction factor in the commercial pipe. It is given as 1 by square root of F minus 2 into log 10 of R by K equal to 1.74 minus 2 into log 10 of 1 plus 18.7 into R by K divided by Reynolds number into square root of F. So, here the parameter, so this equation is plotted in the Moody chart. And here we require the K value, we will find out the K value. So, the Moody diagram or the Moody chart. So, L.F. Moody plotted the equation. So, the previous equation, the equation number 23, he plotted here by taking Reynolds number in the x-axis and the friction factor in the y-axis for various values of K by D, commonly known as Moody diagram. So, for any turbulent flow of the in the pipe, the value of friction factor can be determined from the Moody diagram if Reynolds number and the K by D values are known. Now, this is the Moody chart. So, look at here. Reynolds number the x-axis and the lines for different values of K by D. So, K by D, actually K is the factor, the parameter, and D is the diameter of the pipeline. So, the dotted line, outside the dotted line, it is completely, fully rough turbulent flow. And this is the line for laminar flow where F equal to 64 Reynolds number, and in between we have the laminar flow, transitional flow and turbulent flow. It is outside, it is completely turbulent flow. Here we have the transitional flow between laminar and the turbulent. And for the commercial pipe, the K value for the commercial pipe, it may be taken as steel, wrought iron 0.045 millimeter. Asphalted cast iron 1.12, galvanized iron 0.15, cast iron 0.26, concrete 3.0, riveted steel pipe 0.9 to 9.0. So in the turbulent flow, you have to prepare for the discussion or a small discussion on the Moody chart, how to use the Moody diagram for calculating the friction factor. And if at all they ask a problem in the turbulent flow to calculate the HF value, the F value will be given. So, when the F value is given, friction factor or the friction coefficient is given, then you can use the HF equal to 4FL V square by 2GD. Using that, you can calculate the head loss due to friction. So, the friction factor is the critical parameter for calculating the head loss due to friction. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I published in Mechanical Engineering. So, design of transmission system, turbo emissions, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering, and you have a book of fluid mechanics and machinery which you can refer for additional information on this topic and the problems in the fluid mechanics and machinery. Also, I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures on the subjects mentioned here. Also, video lectures on the gate solution, the solution for the gate question paper. So, you subscribe to the channel, use the video for your better learning and to pass in the gate examination. So, thanks for watching. Please post your comments. So, you subscribe to the channel and contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. So, we'll meet again in another video on the subject fluid mechanics and machinery.